September and the 30th of September as a true record. Everybody all right with that?
Yeah.
To receive reports from first the County Council.
Yes, thank you. Well, first of all, I put an incinerator motion against the Wisbeach incinerator on the Norfolk border to the County Council last Monday, the 27th, but unfortunately it wasn't supported by a lot of the people who don't live in West Norfolk. And this is quite a cause of concern because Fenland and Cambridgeshire and the Borough Council voted for an in-principle rejection. So I'm, taking this further, and I've set up a gang of six again, like we had to get rid of the South Lynn one. Because looking into it, there was a study that said that it, can affect children, congenital heart defects and reproductive issues if they live near incinerators. And this one would be so big, 625,000 tonnes a year. Instead of recycling plastics, people would be burning them, and if we weren't producing the plastics, it would be brought in or shipped in. And a great concern is that the firm MBB Energy have refused to do a study on what would happen to the local area if there was an accident, and that's being picked up for the Borough Council. But I found out that Medworth, MBB Energy, their ash from their Plymouth incinerator actually blew up a ship and injured the chief engineer. So they've had accidents and regulation has failed. So although it's now considered to be national infrastructure, I'm going to take this up with the leader of the County Council again. And I put in a question about what sort of evidence they needed, because they said they needed more. But they're trying to sort of kick the can down the road, so I don't think it should be stopped. So thank you to everybody who's been writing letters to the leader of the County Council, the Chief Officer, and I'd encourage you to keep doing so. Department, on the 505 bus, I've taken the non-appearance of various buses up with the county, who spoke to Stagecoach, who've assured them that they're running all the buses right now, but they've not been, and I've been, members of the parish council told me about a number of buses that haven't turned up. So that will go to the traffic regulator, because I've asked about the fuel, and the buses, the Stagecoach have access to fuel. Looking at the future initiatives from the county, there's a new community safety road fund, and it's £1 million for West Norfolk, and there can be schemes of up to £10,000 to do with road safety, reducing the speed limit, small schemes. Now, as we know, some of these can be quite expensive, like the one that people thought about having near Robin Kirk and Wade would be £14,000. But I would like the parish maybe to think about that, whether it would like to recommend something in Clenchwarton. Obviously, also for the local member fund, because that would be something which would be quite good. And actually, bearing in mind that after campaigning for the lollipop person to be restored, because the county had a policy of not renewing the post when people retired. And after Belinda Chalk retired, the post has been vacant and a traffic congestion problem emerged in Small Holdings Road because parents at home time were driving in, not wanting infants to cross the road. So I said that I would pay for this out of my local member fund, but county contacted me and said some funding had been found for it. But nobody's applied. The advert went out to the school recently, but of course it might suit a retired person rather than a parent that wants to be at home around, sort of 3 o'clock. It's for half an hour each day, I think 8:30 to 9-ish, and then 3 to 3:30, that's sort of roughly the times. And it's sort of during school times, obviously. If anybody's interested, please contact me or Adrian Buck at Norfolk County Council, because it would be really good. I think some people looking interested here who might like to take that on. So that would be really, really good. The houses at the top of Hall Road, there were complaints from a resident about water running down from the access of a building site onto a driveway, and so I called enforcement about that, who went to look. Also about dust. So the developers have agreed to have a site management plan for dust, dousing down of the dust with water. They've got to keep a record. But enforcement said that because of the camber of the road, there wouldn't be a problem with the water running down. Well, I said this has happened since this access has been there, so you want to keep a watch on it. The flooding and main road around the chapel, I've asked for another meeting with the planning people from the water management and Angling Water, because they've put a non-return valve onto one of the houses, but Angling Water fixed it wrong, and the next door neighbour's got the flood problem. So it's thought that there may be more than Angling Water's letting on, so I've asked them to give me time for another meeting. And then just a couple of other things. The County Council is going to increase its help for local businesses taking on apprenticeships from £1,000 to £2,000 under the Retain, Reward and Recruit campaign. So that's something which people can get in contact with. And lastly, the very sad case of the three people with learning disabilities who died at Causton Park Private Mental Health Hospital in Norfolk. The report came out and these young people had died after neglect and abuse. And the County Council had abolished its Adult Social Care Committee, and this issue wasn't coming to the Health Committee. And the Clinical Commission Group said that they got their procurement wrong. But this is awful because it sort of happened in plain sight. So I put questions to the County's Cabinet about what more we can do to monitor this. So this is a very quick round of the things that have been happening in the last month. And are there any questions, please?
Just one. I've got a school crossing thing, but I can't put it on the thing. The closing date's on the 10th.
Yes.
So if I even get it up tonight, it's not going to be up for 3 days. But I will put it up to the closest one to the school.
Well, I think there should be an extension of the deadline, because we need one. And I've suggested, because the fire service have taken it over from children's services. Yeah. But, I mean, it would help, I think, to solve the traffic problem on Clenchwarton, on Small Holdings Road, because that obviously is in part due to school home time. But equally well, a retired person, I think it would really suit, so it needs to get... you could put on the notice to subject to extension.
Do you know what, if you do get it extended, yeah, you'll be able to send it to me by email and I'll put them on the notice board.
I will. I'll write to Adrian about tomorrow morning.
Even if it's just a week, at least.
Yeah,
it's,
exactly.
Week.
Yes, it is.
Something that's this Sunday, so.
Yes.
On the incinerator, I think you said last time that the chimney is 95 metres high.
Yes.
That's 300 feet, isn't it? I remember yonks ago when it was one single windmill at Swaffham before they started to develop everywhere. So going back in the 90s, you could see it from Knight's Hill. Well, those windmills aren't 300 feet high. Now this thing down at Wisbeach, which is just about the same distance, I mean, you'll see it from somewhere in King's Lynn. This is absolutely extraordinary, isn't it?
It is.
I hadn't quite tweaked how bad this could be.
And the open landscape, they're completely... There's nothing in there, in the pre-environmental impact assessment about the force of the winds and the fact this is an open landscape from Wisbeach to here. They just don't want to know, and that's what worries me, because the county said, oh, we'll put in a response when it comes to planning, but that's going to be too late, because we know what the planning process is like from our trouble with the last one. So I think it really does take everybody's effort to send letters, maybe a petition, because the county administration has not got the message. It really hasn't, and that is very, very sad to see.
I did send an email. I don't think I got a reply.
Well, they will read them. They will read them. Yeah, thanks for sending that, because it's so important.
But 300 feet is enormous.
It is, isn't it?
Anybody else? Stopped, I'll be using that, so they double the fuel cost. Apparently, I've asked the school to
said about this community Gloucester starts when?
3rd of November.
And what do we know about it? What's the...
Well, each council, borough council, will have £1,000, like county, I mean, you know, 10,000, they are coming to spend on different things. Because I've got two parishes, I've got Clenchwarton and Tilton North Saint, so that £1,000 I'll have to split between it. Anyway, I'll split it, I don't know yet. But it's that there will be a plan, so. But that's just a small thing. Or in groups in the village, if somebody come up, they want to organise a party for the Queen's birthday and a holiday for all the children in the village, then they can have some. So it's not just parish council.
When does that have to be in there, you know, to let you know?
Well, let's start up with the hands and train before that, so we got up and...
So you haven't got a time and an end date when it needs to be in before you decide?
No. You don't have to start asking first to do it. So we'll say, I've still got to do some bit and help out with the boys, so grabbers and jacks, so the parish can have to keep them and that sort of thing.
I'll let them down on this, they might make it.
Eventually drain away if they leave it long enough. I did when we first moved in, I can't said, this is to do with Norfolk County Council because it's not sewage or fresh water. It's, I don't know what they call it.
Stormwater. That's fine.
So they said it was Norfolk County Council to deal with it, but I've had no contact from anyone at all on that side of things, despite...
Alex,
didn't you challenge the drainage on the plumbing that had to be sort of rectified before the entire building?
Yes, I did, and this is, I reminded them of that when I wrote to Borough County about the general issues due to the flooded entrance to the person living along Hall Road opposite. And I said, you know, I went to the local plan hearing in 2015 to tell the inspector, and he said everything had to be sorted out. But they said that the borough said they passed the pre-drainage plans. Well, I said, this can't be right if you're getting flooding. And they didn't want to say there was anything wrong, but I said, you know, this has happened. So we need to keep pressing with this.
Whether the two are linked or not with Hall Road, I'm not sure, but I certainly know there's a problem with the drainage and the way in which the drainage is working, and it's not fit for purpose. It's what I would say in our business. It's not working, and I'm not getting any response from the channels that I am pursuing to try and rectify the problem. So I don't know where else to turn, really.
It's something that you think it's going to do, because I've done St John's Crescent about 10 years ago now, and we're never flooded.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, it looks as if it's recent.
The drainage, the design of the houses, that comes, the water comes off the roofs into drains that then go out onto the street, and then sort of balance out.
Yeah.
But from number six onwards, it kind of starts to cascade up, and I know friends who have lived in that, lived further up at number 11, and they've said that when they used to have heavy rain, it used to kind of flood up as well. So it just seems, it seems as though it's kind of catching the water in that area, and obviously Hall Road is higher, St Anne's lower, and it just seems to be catching all the water there.
Well, we never flooded.
Highways to go and have another look, because they did have a look and they didn't seem to see a problem. I said
rainfall in shorter periods of time. Yeah. So whereas previously they would have allowed for drainage over a certain period of time, yes, ordinarily it's okay, but when you have intense rainfall, which we've had, I don't know, four or five occasions over the last year, it is bad, and we need, I think, to deal with the greater volume of water. So if they leave it 6 hours or 24 hours and come out, they go, there's no problem, because they can't see
the
problem.
That's the trouble, they went the next day and she'd gone, you see.
Yeah.
Has it happened since then?
It was July. In July, I haven't seen any, but to be honest, when we had the heavy rains the other night, it was overnight, so by morning, it could have settled at that stage. I didn't get up at that sort of time of night to see what's happened on it.
Thank you, Andy. I think the house opposite is
I'd completely forgotten that this is the grant window, isn't it? In the same vein, the Neighbourhood Watch are looking to renew some of the signage around the village, so I'll probably approach Judith and put the same request in. Thanks.
That's it. Next one.
Thank you.
You have to look at the numbers. But it was a
on the amount.
Still actually aren't being charged.
Sorry?
Still actually aren't being charged.
More than that. This is the company that I've used myself. If you want to go elsewhere, you won't find there are too many. They all go to the same company, by the way. They all end up going to the same place, yeah. Which is quite funny. The only difference is what they offer. This company, you get a free bin. They supply the bin for free. They don't have to charge for delivery. There's no rental charges. No long-term contracts. And they provide all the documentation. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See? Yeah, Chair, usually up and forth before them at several meetings over the last couple of years, you take a real umbrage to comment to people on Facebook by councillors and councillors speaking to the press. At the time, you've never been willing to receive any sort of explanations to what happened, why, over the last interview, etc. And you promised that you would personally report any future breaches to the monitor. Mm-hmm. You then adjourned it and assumed the media policy was updated. Yet here we are, only months later, with the breach of that policy. You draw that policy.
Can you just mention anything?
I myself have been approached three times for comments since I've updated. I've refrained from doing so. And I know other councillors have also been approached to refrain from saying anything. On the 17th of September, an article appeared in the Lynn News. As per the policy, I was not informed of the statement that was going to be made, nor did I give authority to speak on my behalf. Nor did I agree with it, or ask for permission to make any statement, all of which is in the policy. Mm. Speaking with other councillors, they were neither shown disrespect either. Mm. In the article, it said the Parish Council spokesman claimed objected to the CCP project were trying to disrupt and delay its progress. The spokesman also claimed he didn't hear us at all about resignation. Mm. And this spokesperson not see and understand that it's this arrogance of just crack on with it. Forget the facts that is causing the problem with the CCTV. The village has been misled for a considerable amount of time in this project. And if we are going to continue, we need to get it right. We need to remove the bullies, and we need to start from scratch and document absolutely everything. I've asked for years to see the documents and evidence, and nothing's been reached. I'm overwhelmed to ask for it so that I can understand where I've got to be talking. I'd like the following questions answered, and I'll read them all before we even answer. I'd like to know who breached the policy, and as Chair, will you be reporting that person to the monitor? If not, why not? And who does a spokesman believe is trying to disrupt and delay the project? The first question, Chair. I'd like to know who breached the policy. Okay.
Yeah.
So second question then.
Yeah.
How are you going to report yourself to the monitor? As you promised to do so.
I could do, but first I'd like to explain. What I saw is quite a few people that have put a lot of lies in the news, and I don't know if somebody knows from this village, Alistair, can't think of his second name. That's him, yeah. But he always seems to phone or text within a few hours of him. He gave me a deadline of about 2 hours, and I think he's doing that on purpose so we can't reply.
That's been standard on all the other previous occasions.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That is how the press work. Yeah, it's very big flash.
Yeah. I mean, there would be no way going on that we'd be able to get everybody, in fact I don't think I'd get anybody unless I found them direct. I would get their permission to say something, and what would we say? I'm fed up, Steve, of people lying in the press, yeah? Fed up, yeah? Because I think we need to hear the truth. Now you tell me any time that I've told a lie in the press or any other, and you won't find it. I can name instances, which I'm not going to go into, just instances, individual instances of lies being put in the paper.
chair.
Yeah.
Isn't this not slightly convoluted? I'm annoyed by hearing this because I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I haven't read the article, so I'm not privy to the article. But the fact that where we are now is a few months back, someone spoke to the press.
Yeah.
And out of that, we were forced.
Yeah.
I use that word very forced. No, we were forced. No.
I think it
people who signed that letter.
Yeah.
And you know that I try and take a measured approach, but I also like to say what I see. And you and I have spoken in the last couple of weeks. Yeah. If you think I've told lies, or anyone else, then I would have expected you and I to have a grown-up debate about it, where we can pick the bones out of stuff. To sit there and just say that people have been telling lies, it's not on, really, because, I mean, no, you may not agree with what I think, and I may not agree with what you think,
yeah.
But you can't just turn, you know, I take matters really seriously. When I put my name to something, and it was in the paper on the same day, it's the same edition of the paper, you know, people have a right to, there's a public right to reply. Anyone can write into the Lynn News. I don't have to seek parish council permission to say how I see things, you know, but I do feel a sense of disappointment that you're sitting there tonight saying the people who wrote those letters are telling lies, because that's not the motive.
I said there's been lies in the papers before. Yes, they are.
No, you said when he got in contact with you, people have been telling lies.
I'd have to have the piece in front of me to go on with you what I meant. But I need to see the piece in front of me. I can't think off the top of me.
I think more measured remarks and comments could be in order. Because,
yeah,
well, you know, you and I can talk the hind legs of a donkey to each other,
yeah,
at any time. And I'm always open for a chat with you, Kevin. So,
yeah,
you know, it doesn't. These sort of statements are not helpful in a public forum.
Yeah.
I'm disappointed.
I'm happy to leave it if all parties are going to learn and not speak to the press again, and if they are, then everybody gets someone to get notified and try to speak as per the media policy that was voted.
If anyone else had spoken to the press, you would have been down on them like a ton of bricks based on previous meetings.
As the spokesman, I mean, I did ask my name to come out for a certain reason, I know the reason, but and asked him to be spokesman. But in future, I was angry at that time, to be quite honest, and it's not a right time to say something. Yeah.
Well, I would expect that there are a lot of people who are angry at being called a liar.
I should imagine, but
yes, at my council are furious. They are not liars.
If you want me to specific certain aspects that I think the lies, I can gladly go through.
I've gone through all of that article,
yeah,
and I know that every piece of information in there is the truth,
yeah,
and it's all backed up on the YouTube by videos of this meeting. So they're not lies at all.
Yeah.
You need to start reviewing those meetings and look at what is the truth and what is not the truth, because you are doing serious damage to this council.
Finance, please.
You've got in front of you the payments schedule, which is this
Next chair charge, number 9, to consider trip plan. Sorry.
No.
Just read from PKA Little John. We concluded our review of Clenchwarton Parish Councils and issued our external auditor report to Stillingford. The opinion was unqualified and included three other matters that did not affect our opinion. Stated that we had not received certain documents and explanations which were requested in order to be reviewed. This was incorrect, as a smaller authority had in fact provided this information. We apologise for this error. Unfortunately, once we issue our opinion and certified closure, we are unable to reissue our report. However, this email may be published with the external auditor report, and that's what we're looking to do.
Yeah. Can I just check? Yes. Well, you got that email as well, with the grants for the clay plant, we have to provide the council. Can we do that by using the AR report? Obviously, if they're going to give us a grant and there's a page full of errors, it could get that coming. So, if we've got that, we include it in the grants, then
yeah,
can see why.
Gotcha.
Are you going to mention that they're not correct yet when we hand it in?
Yeah, we've now got the AR statement.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
If we've got the EDL in with it, right?
Yeah.
Now we can go to number 9. To consider tree works in the closed churchyard. As well, as you can see that they've probably been half.
Yeah. back to the diocese for permission first. If we can take them down, that is. Yeah, just locking them down, then that's okay.
So, is it as simple as just writing asking for permission?
No, there is a legal process. The PCC will be involved as well.
Which board?
Sorry?
The Deborah.
Yeah, Deborah, church board. Well, Barbara Burton, of course, is the rector.
That might be a first port call, but
Because
if they're okay,
You know where she is. She's at the rectory at what place of peace.
Then go out to diocese after that.
So what are you thinking? Then be attended after you've got more information?
Yeah, so that's probably the case about it.
They might
Say that.
Chair, I would say if anybody wants trees, there's a scheme with the County Council for planting a million. And sometimes it's quite difficult to get them planted because of landowner issues. So
do you want the details for that, Alexander?
Well, just sort of contact me and I'll get Highways to go and look because they seem to be the first point of contact. But we need trees. We're going to try to get some on the A17, but there have been landowner issues there. It's been rather difficult. So very welcome to hear.
Is that a variety of trees or is that one species?
I can't hear.
Do we get to choose what variety of tree you want?
Well, certainly you could ask. Yes, they should be flexible.
That's what we've done. That could be an option.
And also, we would like to go around with them. Let's have a problem back here.
Okay. Thanks very much,
Right. Number 11.
up. Obviously, we get stuff from school. I hear things from my lads at school here, and you do hear things from it. But I'm just wondering if there's a way that better things can be communicated out to try and encourage people to do the positive things and to do the right things. I'm sorry, I know I'm
hear what you're saying. I mean, we're not supposed to speak out of the meeting, but what we'll do is, the best thing to do is get the guy here, and then people can ask him directly the question rather than us come up with a solution, because that's their job at the end of the day, and we have tried before. I mean, I'd be quite...
Can I think, you know, Steve's point about how we've been defeating it is, and that does make it a police matter.
Yeah.
And people get it really into trouble. But, you know, if a policeman were hanging around, it might change the behaviour. They could be persuaded to attend for a day or two. The other thing is, I assume that most of the children at the school live pretty well in the village or pretty near it. I wonder if the school ever thought about those walking buses, which are sometimes organised in urban areas. That might
Did they?
And it stopped now, didn't it?
Yeah. It was one of the reasons why, it was one of the outcomes of having the car park, the basketball nets on. The idea is park there, walk the child in. What they were going to, I don't know if they actually did, was have someone from the school go up there, find this, etc.
Yes, yeah.
You know, take the children, walk them in, parents can go.
Well, it can be parents on a route.
That sort of, you know, close to school slash PCA kind of things. And I think I did suggest that the last time I was thinking about that, going direct to the school, academy, might be a better approach. The academy as opposed to the school.
Yeah, that's true. Isn't it?
Yeah, if you go to the academy, you might get a bit more traction rather than going direct to the school.
On a daily basis, like a car park near basketball court, it's full of
students.
Do we look at increasing that car park?
I mean, I think it would help, but I'll tell you, you know the guys on small landings that park there, or wherever it is?
Yeah.
Some people want to get as close to that school as they can. They're not bothered about walking 100 yards.
Yeah.
Even if you had a multi-storey car park, they wouldn't go there. They would, if they could, they would park next to the gates.
Yeah.
Why not a walking bus stop?
I'm not sure, because it's certainly way more than the light is just to...
There was a big thing about a load of funding, maybe the funding stopped.
You needed funding?
Well, the paying young teachers that are doing it.
Yeah, but parents can do it.
Well, parents can't.
Can they not?
They want to be legally responsible, and they would have got their own...
They'd be legally responsible if they was parked there and somebody got knocked over.
Yeah, but not legally responsible for 20 kids.
Yeah, I know, I'm sorry. Anyway, moving on, can we get the clerk or the...
I would support the white lines. School has been written to, and I notice it's put it in its newsletter to parents asking them not to park on small holdings.
I mean, at least we can talk to him direct, and he'll give the same answers as last time why he can't do it. But, you know, if you get a lot of people come that use the school, you know, or live around that area, then at least they'll know.
When you say white lines, you mean yellow lines, do you
think?
There's a spin-off agenda item. Do we want to look at the increase in the size of that car?
Shall we wait till it comes for this, and then see what he says, and then we can relate to what he says after that. You know, the best thing. To discuss issues at the island, Wash Lane or Road, Steve?
Yes. I'd like it put forward for the next precept that we talk about having the island at Hall Road, Wash Lane, Clapper Lane, where people are still persistently cutting the corner. We talked about it. Alexander got in touch with, I'm sure it was County Council, had a map of the island at the junction there. We brought it before the council. They decided to buy two gates, which hasn't been installed, instead of looking at discuss it.
We can, but we have discussed it, I believe, but they were waiting for you to come back with a question to take to the people in that area, and then there was going to do a survey.
Right, okay.
I believe that's how it finished.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Will that progress this council to getting the job done?
Sure.
can't say
and
that.
Before that. And before that?
How about that?
You see, I'm not saying I know everything, but just make a point. Sorry. Alan's got time. Right, just a simple point, that if the drawing's already been done, because I think I've seen the drawing, surely the high-based people will then use their own procedure, which may or may not include asking people who live around the thing. So it's like a procedure.
Why don't we wait? If we're inviting him next week, why don't we ask his opinion on that junction?
The high-based people said it was a low priority case, and that's why they're not interested.
The women touched the right of us.
They said it's a low priority. I was there that day.
So that.
And
that's only coming, that's not going down Hall Road, that's only coming from Clapper Lane.
No, there's
what I'm saying is there's the problem at the junction, but the junction is a wide area. There's no restrictions of vision. No.
The main problem is turning into the junction, not coming out of Clapper Lane.
Mm. It is.
Yeah, it's not coming out, it's turning in, it's coming down Hall Road and cut in the corner to go down Clapper Lane. That's the issue.
That's the one.
That's the issue, and also HGV and lorries doing the U-turn at that point.
Alright, we'll move on. Okay. We'll go on from there. So the next one is to discuss...
Look at Boy Lorin in the village. A little roundabout, which you just pointed out, is dangerous.
We're just going on to that. So, yeah. To discuss white line on the village roads, including the Hall Road and Romney Kirkham. This is what I believe somebody wants to talk about, so we'll talk first. Is that alright? And then we'll close the meeting for 7 minutes and then open the meeting again. So, that's the same thing, Steve. So anyway, so what have we got to say about anything white lines before we open it up?
Well, I'd like I brought this up, and I'd like it to be looked at where the pedestrian crossing is all the tarmac as you come from Lynn. That way, it's all the tarmac is breaking up. The line is very, you can't see it very well. The little roundabout as you go down Hall Road, that's terrible. You can't see it very well. There's three street lights, what's been out for about 4 months, in the over that junction there.
What, on the main road junction?
Yeah. But all the white lines in the villages at the junction are really different.
You wouldn't have to know what numbers they are.
No.
Alright. And that's on main road, three lights out.
I've
got to go for it.
There's the walk. I'll tell you which ones they are. The walk through, where you go with the chippy, just here. Yeah? Where you cross the road. That light there is out.
Yeah, yeah.
The one at the other end of Hall Road. Yeah. And the street light, which is over the little mini roundabout.
Okay. In future, if anybody does want to bring up it, they'll have numbers on it. Mm-hmm. If you can just remember that number, and then we can.
They're not hard.
No, but they will have numbers on.
So,
yeah. So, is everybody finished with that? Because I won't go to the lady at the back. Is that alright?
Yeah.
So, I'll just adjourn the meeting. Sorry, I don't know your name.
Oh, that's Chris. I was just wondering because it said white line is going to Robin Kirkham because we've got all the Robin Kirkham if you're sad. Why are they included? Do you?
We just want the junctions.
So that's
Nicholas Avenue, Franklin Close, Hall Road, Clapper Lane, St Anne's Crescent, Hall Road, where the fish and chip shop is,
so
Ferry Road, just all the junctions.
Ah, okay, so it's white line. I didn't know if
you Craig had
put the white line down.
We've got enough speed bumps down there now. We don't want white lines, do we?
Well, no, that's what I mean.
Exactly.
Steve, you want to go down the middle. Can I just clarify? You do mean yellow lines, not white lines. Stop the parking issue then, it's just to remark the lines.
Just to clarify, are you understanding that it's just a junction?
Yeah, I'm just confused by how it's written.
We're okay with that, is that
yeah.
Okay?
And I will agree with the roundabout, the mini roundabout is a hazard. It was terrible. Yeah. They hardly ever let you turn the light, they do come across, and the trees cover the side of the roundabout. Yeah. I don't think the side of the roundabout is far enough back. It's right on top of the roundabout.
I'm not sure about you on the roundabout, but I can't get round the roundabout and turn around the old road. Personally, I don't know about what kind of car you've got.
If
you hit slow, I'm sure.
Yeah. No, if you were around the roundabout, you can't physically make the junction. You can't. You have to cut it. You have to cut it off.
Yeah.
Which is why they put a man
there. So that's just when you're
okay. I'll open the meeting back up then. So you're okay with that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. Everybody else okay with that? Sorry, yeah. You need to ask about the white lines on the junctions. Andy's
going to have a field. So we'll see you right?
Yeah. Andy Wallace is there. Just watch him come down. Okay. I've had to add something on because we forgot to put planning on, and it's only us giving
it's an additional garage next to the houses.
So it's just one garage?
It's just one garage. It wouldn't block anything, it wouldn't block anything. It would be logical for us to support. I don't know if anyone else would look for it.
Can. Everybody happy with that?
Yeah. The next one is 213-014-02 LDP. And this is a certificate of lawfulness, extension of existing roof to form a gable. And this is 9 by 20 plus. Pictures are on the site. Basically, they've extended into the attic for an extra bedroom and bathroom in there.
So the gable line's there, but they're just extending
it to it. It's a new gable line, but out the side of the house. So
is it overlooking anybody or what?
So that's on the side there. It overlooks the neighbours, but not in a way that really affects them. I think there's a bathroom window on the side of the house.
So there's still a house there. The original house is looking that way anyway, so a gable lens is just having an extra window.
Yes. And the only way the neighbours would complain is they've got a balcony down there as well, that's a little better balcony, it looks like it's got this size side to stand out on the side. Potentially you're going to be looking down to the neighbours' garden, so my recommendation would be premier if neighbours.
If neighbours agree,
they will be alright with that too.
Yeah. Would everybody agree with
yeah.
that?
The last one is 2101940, and that's the proposed development of one two-storey dwelling, the land northeast of Ferry Bus. That's on the junction on the mainland. I forgot the old guy's name.
Big
Grayson, yeah, so that's opposite his land on the inside of that bend. And the guy there basically wants to put one house on it with a nice sort of parking bay and a garage, and then put an ocean on next to it. My only concern on this one is people fly around that corner, and where his drive is going to be, it's potentially a dangerous spot.
Is it one way already there, Steve?
So no, it's the site, it's not.
That one was a bit flat, it's quite hard.
No, because I have to show an interest, because it makes me
move. That is my one thing.
That's the piece of
it. Yeah,
that's the side of the
corner. With the auction.
Yeah.
concern for a while that the field doesn't get used enough by sports, and one of the things that Councillor Lucas suggested is the charging structure isn't suitable, and that's been put people off. So we have discussed this at finance meeting and agreed this new policy just for the council. So okay.
That was the email circulated, wasn't it?
Then yeah, I'll say sorry.
Steve asked me for original costs, but I didn't see anything back from them.
Yeah. Nobody's come by. Rob and Steve came back to me and asked what we were doing before, but we didn't actually have a policy on this before. The form basis was set £25 or so.
Yeah. And we're trying to attract people to the field rather than.
So yeah.
Part of that, I made it, is. We do the booking through the website, so Council Lucas will be out connected to the website, and the portion has a bigger sports club then, and make it visible so that people know when to book that field. At the moment, it's completely blank to let the book.
Yeah, that would go on the Parish Council website. So, just like to ask Council to agree.
Has any of the Council's got any questions?
We've also got a meeting in touch with hopefully, the old parishes.
I don't know if Dick and Steve mentioned it, but we also agreed for small tasters, so we can try and entice people to come to use
that. Yeah, one of the things is that new sports would get four free sessions to see if they're viable before they start playing.
It was one of the things that was, we thought we should put to the council. Do we think four free sessions is enough? Do we think six? Do we think eight?
Well, we've discussed this for a while at finance, but I mean, you should get a pretty good idea if you're going to get numbers to make it viable in the four sessions.
What would be awesome?
Well, certain sessions you'll get ready for, others you may not. It, depending on how it is, what the sport discipline is.
Yeah.
I think it needs to be a little bit more flexible because there's certain disciplines where they would want to go through a whole range of stuff that is kind of mandatory in terms of safety, for example. Mm-hmm. Which might take a week, and then before they get into the sport themselves and really get into the thing, what happens a week, maybe two, maybe sometimes even three. So people don't actually get to their hands into the sport straight away. So it could be that it might need five, possibly six.
Leave it at your discretion.
If you left it to my discretion,
I think that
I'll be. I think that's fair, but no more than six.
Could I ask, is there any charge
up to six sessions?
Up to six sessions, yeah.
Is that fine?
Yeah, because I
what, just stick it at six then, or between four and
up,
six?
Up to six. Yeah.
Because Bob's got to agree to it in the first place anyway.
Yeah, I've got to have two guys there explain that and say, whatever discipline is.
Is everybody happy with that?
Yeah.
Can I ask, is there any reduction for regular users?
It's about, not at this point in time, so no, they're not up to the expense anyway.
Right, so a very but dumb question from me.
I think because the football club would be
they don't have an exit strategy for that. They think they're staying, they'll just move on to the next place. If they think very much, do the taster, we're going off to Preston or something. So it has to tie in with whatever's happening in regards to football. And my point by that is looking at what the long term agreement is, using the football as a goal, you know, excuse me, plan, sort of goal post, and finding out what the cost is for them as a long term hire, so that you can apply it to the same as Councillor Bushell said, so that it's the same.
I think you have to, you could have to treat long term hires as a case of work.
Of course,
there's a lot of different scenarios.
I totally understand. I totally agree.
I think we would just have to deal with that as a way.
Yeah.
So let me start, let me throw something out there. The football club can only pay £600 a year.
Right.
They agreed they were going to pay us money for Scar Friday, that was £210. We never had that on the offer, so they hit £600. The only area in the village that is cut 28 times a year, as opposed to 16, is those football fields. Even the children who play for that get little legs is not cut 28 times a year. The additional cost of that cut, is £1,268 a year. That is more than
nothing to do. That's nothing to do.
It's very topical to the debate.
It's not topical to the debate. The debate is whether we have a charging structure to encourage new sports or not.
Right. Can I, again, I'm going to go back to what I just said. If we throw the time back a little bit to when we had the opportunity to do the entire rookie, if they came in and said, right, we want to continue doing that here, please. If we didn't have a long-term plan, a long-term hire agreement, that again was in line with whatever we're doing elsewhere, they're not going to stay. We'll get them in, we'll have a short-term effect with no long-term, again, excuse the pun, goal. So the goal here, in my opinion, is to get cricket in, let's get Wales sport in. They have their taster, it's worked out for them, they've got a few members, they've started a club, it's affiliated, ticked all the boxes, then what? If they don't have a long-term agreement, it ain't going to happen. They're just built to
go. We agree with them to negotiate a contract.
They need to see that in advance. As a sports
we
person,
can't say what it's going to be because we don't know.
I think we need long. The first thing we need to do, surely, is to try and entice people there first.
No. Trust me on this one. If you entice them in and there's nothing to keep them here, why would they stay?
Why would there be anything to keep them here?
Because they've got long-term agreement.
But then we talk about that.
Right, we'll talk about it now.
Or you would.
No, talk about it now. Trust me on this. Talk about it now. They will just move on. We're not going to do it for the sports.
This is designed to get the sports in.
Yeah.
If you want to come back to a finance next meeting and we discuss then the long term scenarios, then that's the place to do it.
That's right.
This is.
But then it's on here, and I kind of agree with what Steve said.
Anybody can speak on it.
Well, he saw the two members.
members of the fire committee have suddenly come up with a brand new idea of plans, which they never mentioned at all in the finance committee, which makes no sense.
With the first respect, I'm not on finance. I was there.
You were there.
I was there.
And you were
on finance.
And
this is my only opportunity to speak. I appreciate I was given the opportunity to speak.
Why would I do finance?
Now, I appreciate the opportunity.
I'm not
speaking
at one agenda like Molly.
I appreciate the opportunity to speak at finance. And what I'm saying is, we're full council now. I'm just saying, at full council, you'd be wrong not to get a long-term hire plan agreement in place in advance. Because the minute, okay, tomorrow, I get someone comes along and they say, cricket, good, well, they started, they've done this 6 weeks, now what? I come back to you, we wait another couple of weeks, months, before we make a decision.
But Rob,
they need to know what the radio stands so that they can we're not achieving anything here. All we're saying is, congratulations, you've had a 4 weeks, 6 weeks of taster. You've enjoyed it for 6 weeks. There is no exit strategy. When we talk at Amari, we always talk about exit strategy. There's no point having tasters if there's nothing coming out at the end. If we haven't anything coming out at the end, what's the point of doing this in the first place?
Rob, we you know, once you've got somewhere, we can have those discussions with ourselves about keeping them in. If we had a cricket club here, you couldn't give them the same structure of what we're saying, because it's
not have a formula. That's what I'm saying. That's a formula.
I just want to see someone here first before we talk about things like that.
Yep.
I think we need to go out and sit in the wrong place.
Yep.
And
But charging to a structure for taster sessions,
when we mentioned it at the finance, we was mentioning this taster sessions to entice people to come and use the field.
Actually, it does say there quite clearly that this is what we want to hire for. So, in theory, yes, this is actually your long term hire.
It is, and that is charging structure for 21 players. That's exactly what it's saying.
Yeah.
Your tasting sessions is the year before that we're now trained to 6 weeks for.
Yeah.
That is your tasting.
So, Steve, you would say, you are saying that the football club, looking at what they use on a Saturday, that they're paying £100 a day. Is that what you would suggest?
No, we didn't say that.
Well, that's just an advice. Exclusive use of both fields, whole day, and.
Yeah, it's just for one-offs. It's not the long-term hire and lease.
They don't tend to use both fields at the same time. They use one, so you put it under the
point.
Which is still considered cheap if you pay elsewhere.
I don't want to talk about it.
So going by that, these you mentioned about, is the council quite happy with going forward with that to start with?
Yes.
May I abstain, because I'm not sure I understand. We have had it, it's the charging structure for the main fields, or is it the taster
section? Yeah, I'm not sure. Confused now, that changes the...
It's one abstain.
That changes in 10 seconds.
The agenda item
says,
just basically charging. This is a charging structure, this is
right. From the finance committee, we came up with a structure that Dick was mentioning just there. Is everybody happy with what Dick mentioned for the charging structure at the moment for that?
And this is for everybody other than long-term users who will be negotiating with.
Any future long-term users will be exactly the same. Yeah. They won't be on this structure because they'll be long-term users. If you honestly think that the cricket field is going to get used for £100, you will not see cricket at plenty. You've got to use your brain sometimes. They're not going to use the £50. They're not going to pay £50 for playing cricket for afternoon. They'll get somewhere else. We can try and entice people into our field because we've only got one sport here at the moment. I think we need to try and get there.
Can I propose one change before?
Right.
Which is to change the title of the charges to punish more players. Adding words to encourage new sports.
I thought that's what we're adding.
Because I should say that.
Well, I know you didn't say that then, but I thought that's what we were talking about. Well,
I believe that's what
we were talking about, charging structure.
Yeah,
full stop.
But part of that, Steve, was trying to entice people in. We've got one sport here.
Hence the free session.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah. Yeah. So we did talk about it then.
Yeah. Yeah. So you're enticing a bit, you just start off the free session. And then you got onto the charges.
And then we took it to 6. So, on the basis of the charging, what Dick mentioned, do we agree on what Dick mentioned about the charging structure? Forget any other structure because it hasn't been mentioned today. Are we happy with that?
Steve's saying, which I understand, that the 4 to 6 sessions are the taster.
That's right.
And this is the structure under which you go after your pre taster.
That's right.
So this is the long-term buyer.
You was there. You was there, Rob.
Yeah, but it's just changed the literal sign.
No,
it's
not.
It's just changed.
He suggested it. I'm going up by what he says on the...
So this is the charge. I came along with a new archery in the backfield. I will get charged 50 quid.
No, because you're not using part of the field.
That's exclusively used for one field.
Yeah, but if you use part of the field, then I don't know what you actually use to that, you get charged £9.
I'm going on, thank you.
Chair, so can you put the third to next meeting, please? How do you first next meeting?
Then we agree with that? It looks quite simple to me, but we're making it harder than what it is, and it is getting close to 9 o'clock.
All I want to see is it did get contradictory
is that really big, that thing that we put on it?
You got a star. You come up the star, okay, on top.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Dave, come. Yeah, well done, Dave.
Can I see that? Does a guy want wind in this tree?
Say again?
Does a guy want wind in this tree? Or could we say,
I think he wants wind in this tree. Obviously, it's donated free, charge, and it's nice to see it all lit up.
So we have
it's in his allotment at the moment.
So we have to
It's in an allotment, and I'll take the allotments at
Westland.
I'll presume so.
I don't know where that is. Let me have a look, see if anybody else can have a look as well. But we need really to.
Can we send our rails to have a look?
Yeah, I don't see why not. I'll go down with you if you want, Ali. We need to make sure it's a nice one. One where there's half missing down.
Would you mind?
Yeah. You know, just in case that isn't any good, can we go ahead with what we went with last year? Is everybody happy with that? Because that was quite a good trip. Is everybody happy? We'll look at that first, but as a backup, we've already got it in place to go away with last year. Is that right?
They have around £500 left from where they're doing all their shops, and they're thinking.